ناظرین یہاں پر آپ کو اہم خبر سے آگاہ کریں گے. آپ کو بتائیں کہ وزیر خارجہ شاہ محمود قریشی تھنک ٹینک فورم سے ویڈیو لنک کے ذریعے خطاب کر رہے ہیں. ملاحظہ کیجیے.
تھینک یو اعزاز چودھری صاحب فار آرگنائزنگ دس دس انٹریکشن. آئی تھنک اٹ بی ویری یوزفل. آئی مسٹ اپریشیٹ ایوری ون ہوز جوائنڈ ان ٹوڈے all the 42 think tanks and the area study centers. It's very important to understand what the academia is thinking, and your recommendations would be very welcome in the Foreign Office, and certainly we will learn from what you have to say, and we will try and incorporate your views into our thinking as it evolves and as things develop. But before I make my statement, Azhar Sahab, could you please allow me to spend a minute on Sayyid Ali Gilani Sahab? As you know, he passed away last night, and I just wanted to share the grief, national grief. The entire nation, every Kashmiri anywhere in the world, whether in Indian occupied Kashmir or Azad Kashmir, every Pakistani is mourning, is sad. It's end of an era. A man who stood firm on his beliefs, his conviction, nobody could convince him. He never bowed. Nobody could buy him. Nobody can coerce him to do anything without his will. He has left us, but he's always he will always be remembered. Every Pakistani, every Kashmiri, every freedom fighter, all those elements who have stood up for basic fundamental human rights will recognize what he stood for. I am sad the way the Indian forces dealt with the family last night. The way his house was encircled, the way they forced the family to bury him without a proper funeral. Everybody knows that there would have been a huge, huge namaz-e-janaza for him, and the Indian forces were too scared to even allow that. We talk of fundamental rights. Is this is, you know, a basic right, a fundamental right, and the way it has been trampled, it saddens me. I am very disturbed since last night when I got the news and I heard this. I am very upset, and I am sure every Pakistani and every Kashmiri is feeling this way. Meri dua hai ki Allah Taala unhe ghareeke rehmat kare aur Allah Taala unke darjaat ko buland kare. Main ye kehna chahta hu ki Sayyid Ali Gilani sahab aaj hum mein maujood nahi hain, لیکن ان کی مہک جو ہے پوری وادی میں, کشمیر کی وادی میں ہمیشہ وہ ان کی مہک رہے گی. ان کی عظمت, ان کا کردار, ان کی استحکامت ایک داستان ہے, مشعل راہ ہے. اور وہ کشمیری جو اس جد و جہد میں سر فہرست ہیں, ان کے لیے انہوں نے کچھ رہنما اصول طے کر دیے ہیں. مجھے یقین ہے کہ نوجوان نسل تجدید عہد کرے گی اور اس مشن کو جاری رکھے گی. With this, let me revert to what you have organized today, Azhar Sahab. Let me begin by congratulating the host for organizing a session on such an important issue. We are witnessing momentous events in our neighborhood which have far-reaching implications for the region and the international community as a whole. The situation demands following a carefully calibrated policy to avoid pitfalls and achieve what we have been pursuing for the last many years, a stable, peaceful and prosperous Afghanistan. Before I highlight the salient points of our policy on Afghanistan, a few comments on the current situation will give an idea on our policy. The international coalition pursued a military approach to achieve peace in Afghanistan for 2 decades, which I don't think was based on ground realities. Insistence on military solution brought the political process to a head. The Doha Peace Agreement brought a new hope for the Afghanistan leaders. Unfortunately, intra-Afghan negotiations made little headway. The absence of an Afghan-led and Afghan-owned negotiated political settlement, coupled with withdrawal of international forces, created a whole new set of challenges and opportunities for Afghan leadership. The lack of resistance by the Afghan security forces and the speed of Taliban's takeover of Kabul have surprised the international community. Ladies and gentlemen, since taking over, Taliban have made a series of announcements on general amnesty, protection of women's rights, freedom of speech, employment and access to education, and openness to an inclusive political dispensation. Taliban are in talks with Afghan leaders on the future political setup. We wish them success. However, the situation as it stands today is fragile. The unfortunate loss of more than 170 lives in 2 dastardly attacks by ISIS near Kabul airport is a grim reminder of fragility of situation. More than ever, the situation demands Afghan leaders to exhibit wisdom. It also requires sustained engagement by international community as shared responsibility to help Afghanistan on its path to peace, stability and prosperity. Failure is no option. Ladies and gentlemen, Pakistan was the only country that consistently maintained that there was no military solution to the Afghan conflict. Pakistan, with its firm belief in a negotiated political settlement, supported the US Taliban direct talks leading to intra-Afghan negotiations. We also continue to voice that the withdrawal of international forces should have proceeded in tandem with progress in the intra-Afghan negotiations. We also supported a responsible and orderly withdrawal to ensure smooth transition. We have suffered the most after Afghanistan, both in terms of casualties and huge loss to the economy. No other country has a greater interest in peace and stability in Afghanistan than Pakistan. Continuation of conflict and instability in Afghanistan is certainly not in our interest. We consider all segments of Afghan society important in the overall construct of Afghanistan. Every Afghan, be it from Tajik community, Uzbek or Turkmen or Pashtun, they all are part of a beautiful mosaic. We reached out to all ethnic communities to reiterate our support to a united and peaceful Afghanistan. In the present circumstance, we have continued our support for an inclusive setup in Afghanistan as the best way forward. We consider Taliban's announcements positive and encouraging. The Afghan leadership should take the responsibility of delivering on the demands of the Afghan people, reconcile their differences, and achieve a negotiated political solution, a long-cherished objective. Inclusive setup is important for Taliban to gain people's confidence and international acceptability. It will open new vistas of cooperation at regional and international level. It will help realize our common objective of a region free from scourge of terrorism, strongly linked with the international community through a web of connectivity projects. Given our renewed focus on geoeconomics, we feel that the dividends of regional connectivity cannot be realized without enduring peace in Afghanistan. To achieve the above, it is extremely important for the international community to remain engaged with Afghanistan. We believe that the biggest opportunity right now is convergence of the international community on the need of durable peace and stability in Afghanistan. A sustained engagement will ensure steady transition and avoid repeat of the 1990s. Afghan people must not be abandoned at this crucial stage. Pakistan will continue to play the role of a facilitator. However, our role must not be misconstrued as that of a guarantor. Ladies and gentlemen, let me and bad yeah.